All right, folks, quick video. One of you guys asked, so after you go through the whole course, what do you do? Very simple. Open up a chart. Have a software that allows you to see a chart. So here you go. This is very basic. TradingView.com. It's free, has a simulator, and you can use to trade any kind of security, stocks, future, forex, CFD, cryptos, indices, economy. It tells you there's a bunch of things you can use within this particular platform. Now let's come back to the USD dollar. Okay, so after you open up your charts and you have your, you know, candlestick chart set up and the moving averages and the volume, stochastics for oversold and overbought, or like in this case, money flow, money stream, on balance volume, those are all indicators that tell you about overbought and oversold conditions. For the most part, they're oscillators. Anyway, back to the chart. Look at the price. What is price doing? So this is the daily chart. You look for a pattern, okay? You look, is the price moving up or moving down? What do you think? Okay, it's moving down, right? This is a high, this is a low, this is a lower high, this is a lower low. See, it goes lower. And then here we found the base. Looks like it stabilized. At this point right here, look at this longer shadow. What do you call this? Hammer, right? It's in the quartz, hammer. So at one point this candle was all red and then snapped right back up. So this is a buying opportunity. When you see this is a buying opportunity. What happened? The following day, price opened higher. See, this is the closing price right here, open higher, put back a little bit, test the support here at 98 and then moved up. So this looks like price might have reached a bottom. So what do you do? Draw some trend lines, pull out these lines, here we go. Okay, so this is a trend line. Here is one, let's put it like that. There. And then if you do a copy of this one, okay, you can put it at the bottom. So you see there is a channel, falling channel, which is what we have just described. High, low, high, low, high, low, high, low. But the highs are lower and the low are lower, so it's moving down. But then here it's stabilizing. So then you can draw some horizontal lines. The horizontal lines, here we go. There. Okay, so this is a resistance right here. This is a resistance. You see this low right here? These lows and highs right here? This is a resistance and support. This is a resistance and support. So most likely, price will be able to test this area right here. Anyway, let's draw a few more. Okay, we put one here, because this is where it seems price to have stabilized. This is a support. This is a support area. You see these lows around here? Okay. Maybe slightly lower. There. 91.35, 30.43. Okay, then we have some other support right here. There. Okay. Let's draw a few more above. These will be resistance areas. And this is not resistance. Go through the course, I cover these things. Okay. And here you go. So those are some of the resistances. Okay, so now the price has been coming down and now it's bounced for the past 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days. Now it's a resistance, it's at the trend line. So what do you do now? Well, a couple of things. You take a closer look at the chart and it's holding the moving averages, the 50, the which is the blue line, the thin blue line, the orange line it's holding, that's the ATMA, the 34, the purple line it's holding, and the 21. So if he's able to break out of this trend line, that's a breakout, and I expect price to reach the next resistance, which will be here around this horizontal level, and after that will be the next resistance level around here, and after that this other next level around here. And if he's not able to break this trend line, he will move lower. He will test the support line right here, which we just draw, the lines, the moving averages, and then here the support, this horizontal line right here. And if this fell, it will come down. So you gotta look at those areas and see how price is behaving around those areas. All right? Then you go inside the shorter time frame. In this case, 1 hour chart. Okay, what is the 1 hour chart telling you? Well, it's very similar. Every candle is an hour and it's pressing this resistance. Hasn't broken out quite yet, so it could pull back and retest the support right here. Or it could test the support down here. This line right here, or failing down here, these lows are over there, yeah? And then you go inside the 15-minute chart. What is the 15-minute chart telling you? It's holding the support, this trend, this horizontal line right here, but again, hasn't broken out. So you wait for the breakout. And then you come back to the daily chart, and then you position accordingly. As you know, this is a hammer, it's a reversal candle, it's a bullish, it's happening at the bottom of a trend, right? We went through that material, right? Downtrend, hammer at the bottom, this is a reversal candle. We expect price to move up from this point on. This seems to have stopped. So this is a potential, you know, 5 days, 6, 7 days ago, this is the opportunity to enter this trade. Now you wait for a pullback. If it comes down, make sure this area right here, the moving average is hold, and after that down here at the support area. But if it breaks out and starts going, there will be another opportunity to enter the trade. And make sure, before you enter the trade, you know where the support areas are. You place your stop losses a few pennies below the previous areas of support, so you know how much you're risking, and then you know where to exit, where you place your targets, which will be by the resistance areas that you just drawn. At that level, consider exit position. Make sure you risk one to make three or four. Risk a dollar to make $3 or $4 of profit. Don't risk one to make one. I hope that helps. Good trading.